Survivor drops 16 to 20 complete strangers on an island where they are forced to work together in order to survive the elements over 39 days. Sometimes these strangers clash, and other times they form close bonds. Some bonds even closer than others. G'day guys, welcome back to Snuffed, where we discuss everything about the greatest game on television, Survivor. Today we'll be playing Cupid as we look back at some of the couples that have formed lifelong relationships through Survivor. We've seen plenty of showmances through the years, and for most, they ended on the island, but some have lasted the test of time. Quite possibly the most iconic of those Survivor relationships was the alliance that has stood for over 15 years between Amber Burkish and Rob Mariano. Amber and Rob were placed on the Shapiro tribe alongside Big Tom, Alicia, Sue Hawk, and Rob C, and they immediately formed an alliance. At the time, the pair began flirting as strategy, but they quickly realised that their relationship was more than a charade, growing stronger and stronger with each day together on the island.
Boston Rob and Amber are going to do it. I don't know when, but they're going to do it. They've got the mat, the pillows, everything is in place, and I really wish those two the best of luck.
After a surprise tribe switch, Amber was swapped to Mogo Mogo as the only original Shapiro member, finding herself in the minority. But Rob made a deal with Lex in order to keep Amber safe, and Lex held up his end of the bargain, with the pair reuniting at the merge. Rob and Amber had their first date after Rob won the Car Award, going to the movies together to watch The Lord of the Flies, with Jeff Probst acting as their chauffeur. They made it all the way to day 39 together, when Amber defeated Rob in a 4-3 vote. But before the votes were revealed, Rob proposed to Amber in one of the most iconic moments in all of reality television.
Amber, you came a long way in this crazy game. I've seen you at your highest high and your lowest low. And between it all, we worked together as a team to accomplish so much. It was really crazy, and in the end, I ended up falling in love with you. You're the most amazing person I've ever met in my entire life. And I want to spend the rest of my life with you. I love you with all my heart. Will you marry me?
After the show, they appeared on the seventh season of The Amazing Race, getting married in May 2005 on national television and returning for The Amazing Race All-Stars. Rob would later go on to appear in Heroes vs. Villains and also win in Redemption Island, having four beautiful daughters between them, and returning as husband and wife on season 40, Winners at War, spending most of their time together on the edge of extinction. Survivor South Pacific's Keith Tollefson and Whitney Duncan started out in the Savoyee tribe together, however it wasn't until after the show that sparks between the pair began to fly. The pair became engaged in February 2013 and went on to compete on The Amazing Race, where they finished in 8th place. Keith and Whitney later got married in July 2014. Another Survivor couple began to date after being voted out. Jack Nicton and Elizabeth Beisel were never on the same tribe when filming Island of the Idols, however the two met in Ponderosa, where they immediately formed a close bond. After the backlash Elizabeth received for her role in The Kelly Blindside, she decided not to attend the reunion show, and Jack stood by her side by also not showing up. Jenna Bowman and Sebastian Knoll from Survivor Ghost Island are another Survivor couple that has developed in recent seasons. The two first met after the tribe swap on day 7, when Jenna stayed on Malolo and was joined by Sebastian, who switched from Naviti. Jenna was in the minority, so decided to begin flirting with Sebastian in order to save herself. She was spared by the tribe, and it led to much more than an alliance, with the pair continuing their showmance after the show. Eric Huffman and Jamie Dugan started out in the Zhanhu tribe together in Survivor China. They bonded together and discussed their personal lives, opening up to one another, with Eric revealing that he was a virgin. Eric and Jamie both made the merge but would have to continue their relationship in Ponderosa after Jamie became the first voted off after the merge. Eric proposed in 2008 and they got married in April 2009. They've since gone on to have two children, starting a family together. Two old school survivors, Kim Powers from Survivor Africa and Alex Bell of Survivor the Amazon, met through the show in 2005, finishing 6th and 7th respectively. Their relationship quickly blossomed and the two became married in August 2006, going on to adopt a daughter together. She was Survivor's biggest flirt when she competed in the Cook Islands, Micronesia, and Heroes vs. Villains, playing as a femme fatale and becoming one of the most legendary contestants. Parvati Shallow had always refused to date someone within the Survivor community until she met John Fincher from Survivor Samoa in 2013. John and Parvati had both signed up to play in a charity soccer game with Ethan Zahn and carpooled together with Nate Gonzalez. Parvati put her dispersions towards Survivor alum aside as the pair instantly clicked together. They married in July 2017 and have since had a daughter together. John would appear as Parvati's loved one for the 40th season of Survivor, Winners at War. Not every Survivor relationship was built to last though. David Murphy from Redemption Island proposed to Carolina Eastwood from Token Chains at the reunion, however they broke up not long after. Likewise, Spencer Doom from Token Chains dated the winner of Survivor China, Top Herzog, for a brief period. Their castmates Stephen Fishback and Courtney Yates also had a brief flirtation. Amanda Kimmel and Ozzy Lust made the Sounds of Jungle Love on Micronesia, but it didn't last after the show, which was also the case for Figgy Figueroa and Taylor Stocker on Millennials vs. Gen X. Michelle Fitzgerald and Wendell Holland kicked it for a short period before ending up stranded on an island together in Survivor Winners at War. Michelle has also dated Pete Yukowski and Dean Kowalski.
Wendell right now is sending me the you up text, and I just want to be like, new season, who dis?
Ethan Zahn, the winner of Survivor Africa, dated Amber Burkish after filming his season. However, it is his relationship with Jenna Maraska that lasted nearly 10 years. They began dating after the Amazon reunion show, in which Jenna was crowned the youngest ever sole survivor. They appeared on All Stars together, both leaving the game pre-merge. In 2009, Ethan was diagnosed with a rare type of cancer called Hodgkin's lymphoma. Jenna supported him throughout his battle with cancer, and they were going to compete in season 19 of The Amazing Race. Ethan and Jenna were asked to return in Survivor South Pacific, but they declined as they did not want to compete against each other. The couple broke up in 2013. Survivor romances aren't reserved exclusively to contestants though, with Jeff Probst dating Julie Berry not long after production wrapped on Survivor Vanuatu in 2004. They made their relationship public at the Vanuatu reunion show and spent 3 years together before breaking up in 2008. Who's your favourite Survivor couple? Let us know in the comments section down below. If you enjoy what you've seen, I'd really appreciate it if you give this video a like and consider subscribing to the channel for all the fixins. New videos just like this one, every Tuesday and Thursday, 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time. That's Wednesday and Friday, Australian Time. For some castaways, their prize isn't even $1 million. Their prize is that they fall in love in this game. Love at first sight. Grab your torches, head back to camp. Good night.
So like I was saying, I'm playing the game. That's what I came here to do. My prize isn't even $1 million. My prize was that I fell in love in this game. Love at first sight. Her name is Candace. And in between.
Candace from Roro Tribe.
Yeah, after the last challenge, we sort of mouthed the words I love you to one another. And so that was my prize. And my prize was her.